see that? Can you hear that? You are currently being exposed to light and noise pollution, two sources of pollution that most people don't generally hear much about. What is light pollution anyways? Light pollution can come from many sources, including streetlights, security lighting, floodlights for sporting events, and lighted advertising. Streetlights are a huge contributor to light pollution. Improperly shielded streetlights scatter light in all directions, where properly shielded ones only direct light at the ground where it is needed. What are some of the harms caused by light pollution? Light pollution disrupts the circadian rhythms of biological organisms, including humans. Circadian rhythms are the internal biological cycles that dictate when an organism is sleeping and when it is active. By disrupting these cycles, animals become more vulnerable to predators and are less awake and aware of their surroundings. Many moths and birds rely on dark skies for navigation and migratory triggers, and brighter night skies due to light pollution are causing huge problems for migration. What is noise pollution? Noise pollution can come from many sources, including transportation sources, heavy industry, as well as more personal sources like car alarms, megaphones, ATVs, fireworks, and barking dogs. Noise pollution has many negative impacts. Remember those circadian rhythms we were talking about earlier? Noise pollution can also disrupt circadian rhythms by decreasing the amount of sleep organisms get every night. Noise from loud boat motors has been shown to increase the likelihood of cardiovascular disease in freshwater largemouth bass. So now you may be asking yourself, what can I do about light and noise pollution? The answer? Lots. First and foremost, get educated and spread the word. The more people who are aware of light and noise pollution, the closer we are to having the support to create laws and regulations to control it. Invest in more energy-efficient lighting. Make sure your lighting is properly shielded and not shedding light where it isn't needed. Lights only need to illuminate the area under them, not the sky and wilderness around them. Proper shielding of lights can severely reduce the amount of light pollution. Be considerate. Be aware of the amount of noise pollution you produce and work to reduce it. Remember that you're sharing the environment with other humans and animals. Don't be overly noisy. The Lower Chippewa River Valley is abound with biodiversity and natural beauty. We don't want that beauty driven off by our overly bright and noisy human lifestyles. In the long run, reducing light and noise pollution will save us money, improve the overall health of ourselves and our ecosystem, and preserve the pristine beauty of our surrounding wilderness.